Hi my loves, welcome back to my channel. I'm Jessica Alexandria of Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is the monthly forecast for Aquarius and Aquarius Rising for the month of April 2019. So the cards that it is that I pulled for you are the card of prosperity and growth. That's positive. And then we have autumn, harvest, and sow. Then we have cattails, which spread seeds. So there's a lot of growth that is happening here. And then for the Rider-Waite, we have Queen of Cups, Ace of Cups, and Three of Pentacles. So right away, as I'm looking at these cards, obviously this is a lot of growth that is happening here. Are starting to happen here, starting to bloom here for Aquariuses. It's funny too, because I just read for an Aquarius last night, a 2-hour reading pretty much, and the cards that it is that she pulled are very similar to the cards that it is that are here and the message. So this applies, I know for a fact, this is confirmation for all Aquariuses, but definitely for her. Franklin's chewing on my foot and then I just got a text message. But the cards that pulled for her, she being an Aquarius, and the cards that are showing up here, they really are acting as confirmation and show that you guys are really in this space right now where the seeds that it is that you're planted and what is being harvested and what is growing here, it is real. It truly is real. But there's another message at the very end that I want you to wait to receive before we cut off, that I want you again to receive. But the first thing that I really want to focus on is again that there is growth, there is an opening here, there is the start of something new. You are connecting with others, you're connecting with a new community. It could be connecting with a new tribe. It's opening yourself up to love, opening yourself up to opportunities, opening yourself up to others, which sometimes can be pretty hard, but you have to really challenge yourself, and we'll talk about that in a minute. But For the month of April with the Ace of Cups, this is again the start of a new beginning, and it's usually something that it is that we love and that we are excited about, or we're emotionally invested in, or have the potential to emotionally invest ourselves in. And it's a very, you know, it's the start of something. I want to emphasize that it is a seed that is being planted here, that is now being initiated, that is now, you know, finally in a fertile environment, and the soil has been created from the things that it is that you've released and things that it is that you've gone through, and that those experiences create the fertility of your, you know, this seed now, this new journey, this new door that is opening for you with your heart, with your intuition, and opportunity all around you. Anytime you have an ending, or anytime you have death, when it comes to the universe and when it comes to these cycles, that death creates the, you know, the fertile soil for what is to grow, what is ultimately going to grow. And that's what it is that I'm seeing for my Aquariuses, is that because of everything that it is that they've gone through, these different relationships or opportunities or people or learning lessons or life, these moments in life, they bring you to this one spot, this one moment in April where there is a seed that is being planted and it wants to grow, it wants to spread. I want you to focus on the potential. I don't want you to focus on the pitfall, because a lot of people have a tendency to do that. The reason why this is that when you plant a seed, you're hoping that it will grow, but it might not, but you're hoping that it will. If you didn't have that hope, you wouldn't be planting that seed to begin with. It's the hope that, and the intention that creates the what can maybe potentially come. I'm sorry, my mouth is, I've been filming in Aquarius at the very end, so I'm getting tongue-tied. But that's what I'm seeing here, is to focus on the potential and to be gentle with it, to be nurturing with it, to be soft and tend to it, but don't overwater it, don't overdo it, because this is just the beginning. Let's say this is a relationship for you. Let's say you've been in a relationship for 10 years, and when you are seeing these cards, maybe in your relationship, there's something that is opening here for you that takes that relationship to the next level of intimacy and romance and connection. So even though the relationship itself is old, maybe you guys are doing therapy, or maybe you guys are learning how to communicate or work together as a team, it's the result, it's the culmination of all the work that you guys have put in that now is the seed, or that created the fertile soil for you to plant this new seed, for you guys to watch your relationship bloom into something new. Let's say you've been single for a while. Then this is, again, you being open to receiving this new love. You being open to connect with, you know, this group or this job or this saying yes to this opportunity because it feels right. It resonates. Instead of looking at it as, oh, maybe this can't grow, or maybe this won't happen, or maybe this won't turn into a tree, or maybe this won't turn into, you know, pay off in the way that it is that I want, still look at it and say, I'm gonna plant the seed because maybe, just maybe it will. If you plant 10 seeds, or if you set the intention 10 times, maybe it's the 10th time that it is that it happened, but the 9 times it didn't. But either way, something is coming to fruition. Something is growing here because of what has happened, what has occurred. And I don't want to ignore that, because what has happened was so important. If it wasn't for the things that have happened in the past, you wouldn't be able here in the now in order to bring this into your life, in order to connect with others, in order to learn and experience everything that it is that you experienced because of the transformations of the past. Now, this is the final message that I want you guys to receive, Aquarius and Aquarius Rising, is that while this is growing and while the potential is growing and while this is happening, it is very, very, very important that you connect and that you don't neglect your private life. And by that, I mean taking time for your inner self, because I see a lot of excitement around you. I see a lot of joy around you, which is amazing and fantastic. But I do see a need to emotionally kind of go within. I'm not seeing you close yourself off or saying no. If anything, it's the polar opposite. But as you make yourself more vulnerable, and as you're saying yes to new things and taking your relationships and taking your life to the next level of potential and growth, I still want you to stay within and connect within yourself, within your intuition, and tend to the inner life. This means meditation, this means prayer, this means taking 20 minutes for yourself or in your work environment to disconnect from the chaos, to disconnect from the excitement, from the joy, from the highs and the lows, in order to connect with yourself internally. Because I just feel that. I just feel that for my Aquariuses. I really feel like that's important. These questions and these feelings that it is that you're having, they're very real, they're very raw, they're very emotional, they're very sensitive. And it comes from a very sensitive, vulnerable space. So I think that if that truly is the case, it's time for you to nurture. Definitely in the month of April, you want to nurture your inner self. You want to nurture your inner life as you're unfolding, as things are unfolding for you. And that's what it is that I see for you. I hope that message makes sense for you. If it does, then go ahead and give me the thumbs up down below. Make sure that you're subscribed and that you have on your notifications so that you receive updates of this video and those to come. And I'll see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.